Hello and welcome everybody. I'm Christian from Berlin. New York state of mind done by a Berlin state of mind. Let's see what that's gonna be. Amazing chord changes that are often surprising, held together by melody. That's a trademark of the Billy Joel masterpieces, and this is one of them. If you want to learn another one, like Just the Way You Are, I Did, or Piano Man, or My Life, they're linked in the text box. Go learn them too. Let's go and enjoy this. If you enjoyed this, leave your thumbs up. Helps my channel to grow and my ego. Enjoy. Hello and welcome everybody to my helping lesson. You will hear a chainsaw in the background in a bit. Here, can you hear it? They just timed it for this tutorial. It's the Berlin state of mind. Maybe it's the competition, they want to destroy me. Okay, we have this wonderful piece. We start with the intro and we see that a lot of 2-5 chord progressions here. We have this 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. You see we have A-7, D7. We will look a bit closer at the chords here, because that helps learning the lessons. Of course, you have to play all these chords and inversions and stuff. So we have this 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. And we have these pop piano fills that you learn from my pop style piano tutorials. Go to my playlist. I teach you all the fills here. And this is, you recall that, huh? Yeah, he stole that from me. Billy Joel, he went in the future with his time machine, and then he looked at my fills, get back and wrote the song. He wanted to call it the Berlin State of Mind, but then changed his mind. It's artistic freedom. And we have this same thing, same little fill here with the 9 and the 3rd. And now we go to G. 4 and 1 and 2 to and 3 and 4 and... And now we are in the key of the song, in C. How wonderful, huh? It's just this intro. G. It's the dominant of C. And third finger here. Play that freely. Play that freely. You can count it. 1 and 2 to and 3 and 4 and 2. Okay? And right hand is very easy here, so we can look at the chords and... Because they would be the same in the second part, a second verse. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. C, all inversions. C. 1 and 2 and 3. It's the E7, which is the dominant of A minor, which is coming up now. So we're going to different little sub keys. One and two and three and four and now 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. What is that? You pundits out there, you knowledgeable people, this is again a 2-5 of F. Just a couple of 2-5s, almost like a jazz standard. And the melody blends in so wonderfully. That's a sign of a masterpiece. If chords and melody blend in wonderfully. So here. G minor 7, 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4, F. And we do the same again. From F, we play the A7, which is again with a 9 in the middle, yeah, gives it a little bit of Berlin spice here. A7 with a 9 here. To the, it's the dominant, A7. To D, D minor. And now we have this. B7, flat B, flat 7. Here's in its entire beauty. And then we have this wonderful little descending line in the left hand. We have this is C. E7 with B in the bass, yeah? We just don't play the E here, okay? C and G and A minor and. And you see all this descending bass line is just brilliant. Well, that's not his invention. It has been used many times. One and. Yeah, great, Christian. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and now we are ending on the D7 and we do our fill from the beginning. Fast here, oversetting, and then we go to. Oh, that's it's just marvelous. These chords are just heart melting. 4 and 2 1 and 2 and F. And we have the kind of intro again. A little bit different the chord here. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 2 and 3 and fast oversetting and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. Oh, and now we have the 1 and 2 to 1 and 2. It's a triplet, yeah, you know that. 1 and 2 to and 3 and 4. And now we do the same with octaves, almost the same. A little bit of T. Yeah, that's good. Okay, 1. So if you are not that good, you just repeat the first verse. That's fine. If you want, now we have the shiny octaves on top. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 2. 1 and 2. Same left hand, you know that already from the first verse. And here we have just thirds.
Hey, that's not that hard. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 3 and 4 and A minor. Here, full chord as before. And you see, just with melody with third. Too wasting too much time. It's gonna be too long, this tutorial. Many people will leave me right now. Yeah, well, basically, here we have. Yeah, we want that. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1. Just 16s, huh? 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. And oh, well, and here we're going to the descending line in the left hand, and to the rising ascending line in the right hand. 1. It's an old Spanish ship. It's an old trick, or it sounds good if the hands go in opposite directions. So we have here descending and here rising. Okay, 1 and 2 and 3 and yeah, this is always the four triplets are always a challenge for the learning piano player, because it feels like chewing gum and it's hard to count. You just have to play it a little bit freely, because it cannot teach you this. It needs two extra lessons to teach you fourth triplets, meaning three fourths over two fourths, like bop, 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 wrong note, 1 and 2 and 3, bop, bop. Just play it as you hear it, really. There's no other way. 1 and 3 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1. And the our beloved now we come to this. It's a strange form he uses. It feels like the chorus is, or the refrain is the beginning, because this now, 1 and 2 triplet, 1 and... Wonderful stuff, huh? We're coming from G, E7 with the sharp 9. It's just wonderfully, a little bit jazzy here. So we have a little bit, sometimes bluesy touches, a little bit jazzy. And the E7 sharp 9 is just the dominant of the A minor that is also coming up. I knew it. 1 and 2 and... So this kind of feels like, because he's telling now, it seems like we are settling now, and he's now telling the story. So it feels like there is just one verse here, and the first bit, like, was the chorus, the refrain. Okay, that's my take on this. So now we have 1 and this. This you can much easier learn from the. I'm just keeping you here. That's really easy. 1 and 2. Now you know all the inversions, all the chords, and now we have the G7, the G major. Is now morphing by magical mysteries into the 1 and 2 and 3, and now it's more, and that's very typical composing technique of jazz. It's suddenly a G7, and of course the G7 smells like a second degree. Let's see if the C7 is coming. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and yes, it's coming. No, this is not anything with E, because it's just the voicing, and then the root is coming. So we have the G7 dispersed over here. So, but it's the G7 and the C7 played with the outer root, and here's the root. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. Now should be coming G7, C7 should be a 2 minor of what? of what? That's right, of F major is the one. And it's coming, we have a 2-5-1, G minor 7, 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3. Wonderful little lead to ah. And this is here where our hearts explode at this chord change. Look at this, he's just coming from nowhere. Well, F major is not nowhere, but well, it's F major. And he dares to go from the F to the absolute bloody unrelated B minor 7. Yeah? That's really weird. Wonderful modulation into... This is the B minor 7, here we have the complete chord as an inversion, and the E7, and it smells again of something, smells of Earl Grey tea, but also of something I learned, tough lesson, don't slurp into my microphone. So we have this wonderful change of tonality from the F major, and suddenly we play this B minor 7, which smells of being a second degree again. So, and then if this is the second degree, the fifth degree would be E7, and that would be the 2-5 of what? Of what, people? Come on, come on, be with me, you know, give a little input. It's a 2-5 of A, and if the A major is coming, we would have a complete 2-5-1 in the middle of nowhere. 1 and 2 and E7. I said it. He stole that from me. And 1 and 2. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. Now, 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. That's right. It's an A major major 7. My look into the future was right. So we have the B minor 7. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and A major 7. Bam. And now the A major 7 is again turning into a minor 7. We had that before. You remember we had the G major 7 turning into the G. Here we have the G major 7, the major here. And now look at this. Ah, we have it again. He did it again. The chainsaw is starting again. It's the tutorial chainsaw massacre. Don't steal the title. I'm going to make a movie. Okay. So we have another change of tonality coming from A major, and suddenly it's 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. Right hand, look at this, four notes at the same time. Time for celebrations, four notes at the same time. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and... Now it's D7 and we go back to G major, you see? And look what he's doing now. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1. Yeah, another 2-5. 1 and 2 and 3, 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and... Which is a F. It's easy to read if you see this as an F with a G in the bass. We could also, and many times in books, it's just noted as the G7 sus4, or even sometimes write the 9. You see my notation, I go for readability. It's always a balance between readability and academic correctness. So. So you always see that balance going to one or the other side. Some say it's an F with a G, but that is kind of denying that it's an G7, the dominant of C. It's not an F chord, but it's better to read it that way. You got my point? Am I complicated? So it's also a G7 with a 9 and the sus4, but that's much harder to read. So, and we need this to go back to
go back to the verse, which is the repetition of verse number 2, nothing more to learn for you. And then we have this outro, which you can really learn from the slow replay, but it's just wonderful. I play it, the chords are just so nice. We come, and now we have this E7 sharp 9 here. Now listen to this. From A minor 7, he's just going straight to the B flat 7. How can you do this? How can you, on earth can you do this? Sounds so great. And now, goes to E flat. We didn't have that in the whole piece. He's just making it up as he goes along. E flat, A flat, and then we have the, we are being led home on a leash, on a harmonic leash. D minor 7, and then chromatically, from D minor 7 to D flat 7 is the chromatic resolution into the C major. Here again, you know, you can always write C major slash 9, but yeah, it's, as I said, it's balanced. So wonderful, huh? He's this final resolution. And then, this is a two of C, second degree, but he does not go, of course he could go like to the G7 as the 2-5, but he does it. Very, very tasteful, huh? Very stylish. Don't call me, this is not in the sheet music. Don't write me email, where is that? It's just, you can do that if you want. Put the pedal down, both feet on the sustain pedal, maybe even a stone or whatever. Okay, now comes the slow replay. I hope you enjoyed this. Thanks for watching.